If you are a rider and want to shoot all your rides, then mounting the camera on your helmet is the best choice, and the chin strap mount helps you just do that. Hi, I'm Kaustubh. Today we are going to speak about chin mounts for action cameras. In the recent years, action cameras have redefined how you record your travel journeys. Be it your riding journeys or your travel adventures, action cameras have made things really easy. Adding to their short, compact nature, it makes them very easy, convenient to carry them. They are much smaller than DSLR, they are much lighter than DSLR, they are easy to shoot. The only thing that you need with action cameras is some sort of mounts so that you can shoot them hands-free. If you are a rider and want to shoot all your rides, then mounting the camera on your helmet is the best choice, and the chin strap mount helps you just do that. Now, there are many advantages of mounting on your helmet. One is it gives you the rider's perspective. Second, it's mounted on your helmet, so as you turn your helmet, the camera also shoots accordingly, so it's very natural. Third is chin strap mounts are removable, so they are not permanent like the curb mounts. They don't damage your helmet or they don't spoil the aesthetics of your helmet. You can always take out mount from one helmet and put it to your another helmet. Fourth point is mounting it on the chin will record all your rides, all your mishaps, all your accidents if you happen to occur any. This might be useful for your insurance purpose. Riders can also review their rides when they have mounted the camera on helmet. What we have here is the Telesyn Chin Mount V3. This is the third generation mount. You might have seen these previous generation blue color mounts. Now these mounts work, but they are not very strong. They might break. Sometimes they can be also a little tedious to mount with these straps. So, Telesyn claims that the new design will almost fit on all the helmet. Let's unbox and see what it offers, what improvement it has got. This is the new mount. You can see the design is completely different. It comes with two Velcro straps. It bends completely so that it can take odd shape of the helmet chin. It's got a thicker back as compared to the previous generation mount. You can see this is much thicker, much better in terms of quality. I think this will absorb the vibration better, and it also comes with a much stronger J mount as compared to these ones. So this looks like a much stronger design. There's also a screw provided so that you can mount your cameras. Now let's mount the chin mount on the helmets and see what difference does it offer. I have two different helmets here, both different types. One is the standard full face and another is a dual sport. So let us try installing this mount and see how it works. So we will first take the full face helmet, which is a Scorpion Exo 410 Air. Let us first put it on the Scorpion helmet. Here I keep the mount. There are two Velcro straps, so both of them will go inside. Velcro strap passes through this loop. Turn it and put it back. Then put the other Velcro strap to see if the positioning is in the center. Now this is a little loose, so I'm going to tighten it again. So tighten the strap here. I hope you can see this. This strap here, just put it on. So this is much easier. Previously there were no Velcro straps, so it was a little difficult. You can see it's a very nicely rigidly mounted. I have my action camera, so I'll just put it here.
can provide with you. The camera is not moving. And if you tighten these straps too much, the visor will not close. So we suggest that you need to keep the straps slightly loose, just enough loose to let the visor close down completely. This is how it will look. Taking off is pretty easy. You just take the Velcro straps and the camera is off. I'll keep the Scorpion aside. And now we have the Bell MX9, which is the boom sport helmet. It's a chin mount, so the front is not as smooth as the Scorpion. So let's see how this mount adjusts itself. Again, the same mounting procedure. Two loops on the strap and let the strap go from below. See how the mount has adjusted itself to the shape of it. I'll loosen the straps a little bit because I want the visor to go down completely. The Telesyn is an official accessory manufacturer for GoPro and makes one of the best mounts for cameras. All their mounts come with very high quality and they last for a decent life. They're much better than those cheap budget mounts that you see on Amazon. The cost of this mount is 1300 rupees as against 800 or 900 of these blue mounts. It's slightly higher, I know, but I would still go for this considering the flexibility of the design that it mounts on almost all helmets. It can take shape of all non-standard helmets also, and it will last much longer than the previous generation mounts. GT House is an official reseller of Telesyn products and you can buy this mount on www.gthouse.shop. You can also find some other Telesyn mounts which could be helpful for your rides, for your record, for your shoots. Do give us your feedbacks in the comment section. Till the next video, stay home, stay safe.